something to say, something to say. Hey everybody, RHOP21 here, and I would like to introduce you to my two newest builds. This is Trey and Deuce. And name's Trey because this is my third wrestler build, and Deuce because this is my second, well, actually kind of third, but second slash LCG based concept. So both of these vehicles are carbon Kevlar reinforced, and I'll go a little bit more into that in a couple minutes, but they're both set up in speed run configuration. They're both using the same power system, so it just made perfect sense to just go ahead and talk about them together because they actually share a lot of features. Those of you familiar with the Traxxas platforms know that there's a lot of commonality even between the Rustler and the Slash platform. So I'll just hit on the similarities and differences as we go through. But first, let me just go ahead and dive in here to Trey. Now you see here, Trey has been fitted or finished with carbon Kevlar reinforcement. And you can see the carbon Kevlar weave pattern coming through the body here. And this is really a cool thing cosmetically, but this wasn't done for cosmetics. This was done for function. As anyone who's familiar with the wrestler bodies know that they're pretty flimsy out the box. So if this was a stock wrestler body, it'd be flopping around everywhere. But obviously this thing is not. And with the carbon Kevlar treatment, you know, it's tough to give to convey strength. But you see, I'm wailing on this thing pretty hard. And there's no deflection. Saves the tank. And the reason why is you see inside it's been fully treated with carbon Kevlar composite. And just to give the cosmetics I want on the outside finish, I had to paint over. Because the stock mesh is translucent, so it lets a little bit of light go through. So in order to give a nice solid color, you know, I just gave it a little backing of the copper there. But as I said, this body is one of a kind, custom hand laid up carbon Kevlar composite. You know, you will not see another body like this on eBay. This is one of a kind, truly unique. And going into the features of the vehicle itself, both vehicles are going to come with the Traxxas TQ radios, 2.4 gigahertz, a good performer. You see a lot of guys using these on YouTube videos and such. And Castle Creations Sidewinder SCT power systems, which is essentially the waterproof Sidewinder 3 speed controller with a Castle factory fan. And the Castle 1410 motor, and I love this motor. I use it on all my cars. It's a four pole 3800 kV motor, very torquey, very reliable. It's just a great motor. But this, I am not including batteries. Just the person who was interested in these models already has their own batteries. You don't need mine, but if everything else you see, you know, is coming, of course, with it. These are using ProLine road rage tires, which I've actually taped so they will not balloon. And just as a demonstration, let me go ahead and fire this guy up. And get his radio. Okay, now that I've got it elevated, go ahead and do a pull and show you guys what they do. So that was a full speed pull with 28 tooth pinion and a 86 tooth spur gear, and that's the gear set that's going to ship with the car. And with 3S LiPo, that's good for over 60 miles an hour. And as you saw, you know, with the full speed pull, no ballooning whatsoever. So these tires taped in this current configuration are actually, you know, pretty good performers. So I'm sure that you'll be able to get out and do plenty of high-speed shenanigans, and they shouldn't really give you too many problems at all. So now, if you notice also, the car has been converted to use Traxxas GTR aluminum springs and they're with The red springs all around, which are about double the spring rate, is what you get on the standard wrestler. And that's important for this configuration because if you're gonna customize it and tweak it for higher speed runs, you're probably gonna have to add some weight, and you have to have enough beef in the springs to be able to support that. Some of the guys are running as much as 1.5 to 2 pounds on these cars in weight. Well, probably more like a pound and a half. But this car has the springs where it will support it and you don't have to worry about it. So it's a great platform to go on. And the pièce de résistance, you see here, I've also incorporated everything I learned about aerodynamics from Slade. Even though I didn't give the front splitter that Slade has, because you know, often guys use, guys like Tinsley Smith are out there using weighted front bumper, so I didn't want to take away flexibility. But I did include the rear spoiler, which is a custom R House contraption, and it works. And I've done over mid 60 mile an hour pulls with Slade with no weights on it whatsoever. This generates downforce, helps get the rear stuck on. So it has adjustability. This is actually an e-revo spoiler, so it has 3 positions. So you have plenty of tweakability to this model. It's built from the ground up with good components all around. And as you can see, it's a pretty unique package. And I think that it is going to be worth every penny that you spend on it. And it's going to be a great platform to have a lot of fun. So let's go ahead and shut him off. Then we can jump into Deuce. Now, Deuce started off life as a slash LCG platinum rolling chassis. And as I've mentioned before, Deuce also is a carbon Kevlar reinforced body. And as you can see here, this just looks gorgeous. And just to try to trim it out a little bit, I lined the window area with black silicone just to make sure that the composite fabric doesn't fray. And you just try to trim it up, try to make it a little bit pretty. It's not, again, the purpose of this wasn't cosmetic. The purpose of this was strength. And as I said, both of these bodies are extremely strong. So again, just a little strength test, Again, you can't really get a full gauge of the strength of these guys from the videos, but anyone who's familiar with the Lexan body knows that if you try to do this type of thing with a traditional Lexan body, it's going to be folded in half. So this is very tough. And so jumping into the vehicle itself, as I mentioned, Deuce also has the Castle Sidewinder SCT power system. And you see here the ESC speed controller, and also is carrying the GTR aluminum body shocks with the red springs, which gives you the extra high spring rate. Again, taped Proline road rage tires all around. Here I've gone with different rims just because I like the bright chrome look with this wrestler, and I like the smoked chrome look here with this with the protoform body. And of course, you have the features like the Castle CC blower in here. This is shipping with the stock 19 tooth pinion 54 tooth spur gear. So again, that should be good for speeds in the high 50s, low 60s with a 3S battery. So, and that's right out the box. But again, these vehicles are functionally identical to Slade and to Dizzy. And Slade's gone up to 68.3 so far. Actually, it's gone beyond that, but up to 68.3 stably. And Dizzy's gone to 65 or 64 and a half miles an hour. And those were on slick foam tires that weren't treated on a cold day. So both of these configurations should be good for well in excess of 70 miles an hour with a little bit of tweaking and a little bit of gearing. and and some good speedrun technique. So I think both of these guys are great platforms for future upgrades, but just out the box right now, they are pretty slick. Well, the thing I forgot to point out, both the cars have already been treated or already been fitted with the 3S, with the LiPo expansion kit. So they'll take 3S LiPos right out of the box. Actually, I think some may even take 4S, some smaller 4S kits. Also, one of the features that I like to do on these cars is I foam line the battery tray. That helps to reduce the vibration, so it helps to protect the LiPo batteries. You definitely want to try to protect the LiPos as much as you can. So you see here on Deuce as well, you've got the LiPo expansion kit, you know, and those of you who are familiar with this know how this works, but I've also got the foam line battery tray. And given that it started off life as a platinum, slash LCG platinum, you know, it does still have some of the little aluminum anodized bits on, like the aluminum anodized, wheel nuts and, you know, inside, you know, like just, you know, a little bit of bling work. But again, this car is built for functionality, not for cosmetics. So, but I still think it looks pretty darn good too. So, now again, you know, just keeping in mind that, you know, both of these cars are done up for function as opposed to appearance. But so, you know, they're made to be real performers with real strength and real capability. But I think they also are good looking vehicles as well. So I try to do a very good job on these bodies, you know, to give you, you know, it's the R House vehicles, so they are carrying an R House paint scheme, but I try to leave enough like open space so that you can customize it with your own stickers and decals and not have to feel like I, you know, took away all of your flexibility with cosmetics. But again, since they're very unique vehicles, you will not see anything else like this out there on eBay. And, you know, and I think that they're awesome platforms for starting out and getting some good speeds and some good capabilities. And there's nothing that says that, you know, this configuration or both of these are limited to just speed runs. You know, I've tried to leave it open. So if you want to do road racing, you want to do, you know, any other application that you want, the car is ready for you. But again, like I said, you're not going to see anything else out there like this. So I tried to be meticulous. You know, they're not perfect, but I think they're pretty darn good. And, you know, anyone who has any questions about them, feel free to send me a message. You can private message me on YouTube and I'll respond. I'll let you know anything that you want to know about the vehicles. And if you guys are interested in seeing some more stuff like this, just let me know. I love building, and some people might say, why am I building things for eBay? Is that, you know, that's kind of like selling out, isn't it? But I like to build. I love to build, but I don't need a whole fleet of cars. So I use this as an opportunity for me to learn so I can take everything I learned from this experience and then roll that into the next build and so on and so forth. So if I don't build, I don't learn. So again, I think that helps us all out because I think that I built pretty interesting vehicles. So, you know, it gives me the opportunity for me to expand my knowledge base, but then it also gives one of you, or in this case, two of you, the opportunity to expand your fleet with some pretty unique vehicles that should have some really great capabilities and give you tons of entertainment. So, as always, remember the mantra, fly, fix, fly, or in this case, bid, bid, bid. And also remember to like and comment and subscribe. Let me know what you like and let me know what you don't. And we'll try to roll that into the next round. So as always, R-House 21 signing off. You guys remember to break it, fix it, and do it all over again. And have yourself a great and a safe time. You know, and by the way, happy 4th of July weekend.